Hello dear Steemans, YouTubers, members of Uptrend and all beautiful blockchain people. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview, so let's start. At the very beginning, I want to announce some very interesting news about our beautiful Steem-centric cryptocurrency exchange called FreedomX. I just want to let you know that first of all, they have listed already the token of Actifit, so Afit token. So now you can trade, deposit and withdraw Actifit tokens. Also yesterday, FreedomX announced some very interesting news. They announced a new partnership, and this will be a partnership with Predict EV. So they're going to list their token on the FreedomX platform, and you will be able to trade this pair against Steem, SBT, USDT, FreedomX, and Ontology tokens. Also, a smart drop of that token is coming. You can read all the details about the smart drop and how to participate. So I'm really very happy when I see that our Steem blockchain ecosystem is enlarging, more and more applications are coming, more and more interesting news, and FreedomX is one of the best exchanges that is connected with our beautiful ecosystem. Also, I want to let you know once again that on the Daybit exchange, this is the HUN token. You can now trade the HUN token. So this is the token of Steem HUN. This is the supply, this is the demand, those are the recent trades. So keep in mind, fellas, that now you can trade the HUN token on Daybit exchange. And now let's switch to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And just to let you know, first of all, CoinGecko has listed as well, or they started tracking the price of HUN token as well. So congratulations to CoinGecko. I'm really very happy. Some very interesting news about CoinGecko are coming in the next few hours. Probably I will announce them tomorrow. And according, now let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to CoinGecko. I just want to let you know, fellas, that Bitcoin is trading now, we see, at the price of $5,202. So it is a significant price rebound that has happened yesterday, actually. So we know that yesterday the price of Bitcoin was close to the level, to the psychological level of $5,000 per one digital coin. Now it is almost 3 or 4% higher than it used to be 24 hours ago, actually, when I did my previous cryptocurrency market overview. So I'm really very happy. And now we will switch to the price chart of Bitcoin. So this is the price chart of Bitcoin, and this is a 1 month time frame. Just to let you know once again that, for example, this is the candlestick for February, this is the candlestick for March, and this is the candlestick for April. And we have this sequence of bullish candlesticks that have ascending highs and ascending lows. To some extent, according to the candlestick analysis, this is a bullish pattern, this is a bullish signal. So it makes me happy. And once again, let me remind you that at the very beginning of March, when the February candlestick for February was formed, we announced that for the first time during this downward trend, we had, let's say, this candlestick that has a higher low and higher high. So it was a kind of the first signal of some bullish sentiment coming at that time. So we still have bullish sentiment persisting at the moment, because we have this sequence of these candlesticks, as I said earlier, with which lows and highs are ascending. So it makes me happy. Now let's switch to a 1 week chart, and on a 1 week chart, last week we had this Doge candlestick. So it is a kind of, let's say, a break, or the market is making some kind of consolidation. And at least after that sequence of candlesticks that has that have higher lows and higher highs, at least the last two candlesticks, they don't have lows lower than the candlestick, than the low of the previous candlestick. So it makes me to some extent happy, because we see that yes, there is some kind of resistance at the moment. The last two candlesticks are very small, but at least they have lows higher than the previous lows. And what makes me happy that even the candlestick of the last week has a maximum higher than the maximum of the previous solid bullish candlestick. So to some extent, it is a signal that the bulls still dominate over the bears. So in my view, although, let's switch to a 1 day chart, although we're still in this downtrend, there is a high probability that the price of Bitcoin will be able to break through the trend line, that is the upper line of the descending channel, and will try to reach that solid red line or level that is close to the psychological level of $6,000 per one digital coin. So let's say 5,800 or 6,000 or 600 to 200s. I think that this rebound somehow will continue zigzag, and we will see that levels, because we saw that on a 1 month chart, on a 1 week chart, we still have those bullish patterns or signals. And I think that it is highly probable that there is a high probability that the price of Bitcoin will be able to break through at least for a short to break through this upper line of the descending channel. But once again, fellas, keep in mind, be very careful, because we're still in this bear market. We are still in this descending channel. This is called a downtrend, because we have a sequence of descending highs and descending lows. So be very careful. But just to let you know, each month I buy the same. I buy a certain amount of cryptocurrencies, including bitcoins. So I invest each and every month the same amount of money. So that's called a dollar averaging strategy, or whatever they call it. So I have followed this strategy for the last 2 years, and I'm pretty happy. That's it today about the charts. Now let's switch to some interesting news regarding the token sale hype, or those initial exchange offerings, and etc. So yesterday I was lucky, because I participated in the initial exchange offering of the new token, or this is the native token of Newton project. And I just want to let you know that I was able to buy some small amount of those tokens. So for example, I invested 25 Huobi tokens. I was not able to buy more, but that was the price at which I was able to buy those new tokens during the initial exchange offering. And after 20 minutes, the token was listed on Huobi Global Exchange, and once listed, its price was at that level. So almost five times higher than the price at which I bought those tokens, and I sold them immediately, to be honest. Of course, it would have been nice if I was able to buy a lot of tokens, but there were some restrictions, and many people participated in this initial exchange offering. But at least I was able to make within a short period of time some kind of decent profit. And what I let you know, I've been participating in many initial exchange offerings, token launches, ICOs on different launch pads, and etc. And in my view, the platform Huobi Prime of the crypto exchange Huobi Global, on which initial exchange offerings take place is the best one. It is the most fair to its user. For example, I think it is much better than Binance Launchpad. On Binance Launchpad, I've never been able to buy some tokens. This is the best platform and I will continue to use it. I will try to participate in the next initial exchange offerings on Huobi Prime. This is the platform for token sales of Huobi Global Exchange. If you have some questions, just let me know right down in the comments. And now let's switch to some news that I want to announce today. For example, I read some kind of post that was published yesterday in the second half of the day, and some of the central bankers, he's a member of the Romanian National Bank Administration Council, he said that cryptocurrency will never replace national currencies, and he said that it's a matter of time when central banks will print or issue their digital coins. And of course, blockchain technology is something great, but institutions will remain the major player in the financial world. This is according to his words. I disagree with this. Of course, we know the central bankers, they have to protect their institutions. They will never say something bad about the current financial or banking system, and they will always say some bad words about Bitcoin and all the cryptocurrencies. But we know that it's a matter of time when cryptocurrencies will start significantly to compete with the fiat money. So it's just a matter of time. I think it's in 5 or 10 years we will see a significant competition between those two different types of currencies, cryptocurrencies and regular or fiat currencies. And the last news that I want to comment on today is that, for example, you know this cryptocurrency BSV, Bitcoin Satoshi Vision, Bitcoin Satoshi Vision, and we know that recently some kind of scandal has arisen about Craig Wright, about his claims, about Bitcoin Satoshi Vision, and we know that Binance delisted. Announced actually that they will delist Bitcoin Satoshi Vision from their exchange. A few other exchanges also announced they will delist Bitcoin Satoshi Vision. For example, Kraken considers following suit. Shapeshift is going to delist Bitcoin Satoshi Vision. And keep in mind, fellas, that you have to check if, in case you have Bitcoin Satoshi Visions, please check on your exchange where you hold them if your exchange is going to support Bitcoin Satoshi Vision or they are going to delist it as well. Of course, probably you will be able, even if they delist it, to withdraw those funds, but it's better in advance to take some steps. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching. That was me at Crypto Spa. Of course, I wish you a wonderful day. And now I will go out because the weather is wonderful. It is sunny. The winter is over. And I will go to have some sun exposure because I need to collect some vitamin D. Have a great day once again. That was me at Crypto Spa. Thank you for watching.